much dialogue with my teammate for this change forum. Ryan had great speech. I don't know what about just cricket skills, but he'll definitely be a very good opening batsman for us to follow up. Exponential, yes. Success via change. I think it's a great topic in era that we live where technology has probably taken over. But at the same time, I think values of people are being taken for granted. I think it's important that we try and facilitate both technology and values together. I think that would be a great partnership. Importance of change, I think that's something that we need to identify first. Why do we need change? It's a very simple way of me putting it across. I'm sorry if I'm picking on the ladies, but it's like a hairstyle. Whether you want it short, shoulder length, long, how do you want to maintain it? It's that simple. It's an individual challenge, how you want to perceive, how do you want to express yourself, how do you want to express yourself with things that is around you, and things that you have learned over the years, which is sometimes you've taken for granted. I think the most important thing that you have to realize is that everyone has a foundation. Everyone has a foundation to build on, and how you build that. When people forget about the foundation, that's when you don't understand where your direction is. I think the foundation is the most important thing, the upbringing, the learnings that you have, and the hours and hours and hours of time that you spend. I think every day you learn something, and how do you manage that and look to the future and make those changes? It could be in your office environment, it could be on your own doing something, it could be the mindset that you need to change, it could be anything. I think if I just take a few things here and there are so many opportunities, there's so many ways of you changing yourself, people around you, the corporates that you're involved with, and that is how, like Ryan explained, that little changes have evolved over the years, and where we are right now in 2018, and it hasn't taken long, maybe from the 1920s to come to 1970s, it's taken 50 years, but since then, the changes have happened so quickly. Some have taken 20 years, some have taken a year. So the speed that we are traveling right now, I think there's no room for complacency. There's no room for people to think twice, but to evolve and embrace change. I will take a few antidotes from sports, to see whether that can be related to the changes that we had to make as cricketers. Obviously, you saw my mate smiling away in that advertisement. We both made our international appearances about a year apart, 2 years apart, but we realized that the modern day cricket was going in a different direction, and we needed to make changes. And obviously, the domestic cricket structure that Sri Lanka possessed at that time didn't allow us to do that. But we alone started thinking differently. We were looking at ways of us individually, how can we improve, how can we change our training methods, how can we be different to what everyone would perceive us, because the technology was catching up. The analyzing methods were much, much better. So if we play to a certain pattern, it's quite easy for our opponents to see our weaknesses. So we then started training differently. We kept changing the way we bat, the way we look at test cricket, how we looked at one day cricket later on, obviously, latter part of our career was T20 cricket. So the technology played a big part, but at the same time, that instinctiveness, that how we want to evolve, took us to a different level. Without making mistakes, you will not learn how to get things right. It's the ones who actually put their hand up and acknowledge that you made a mistake, but the processes that you had followed, if it's right, and then you will realize where you made the mistakes, and then you can still make those changes and move on. So that was the early part of our career, how we had to adapt. And then the second part of our career was something that was interesting. We realized that we had to prepare ourselves after cricket. And I know it's a huge a mental barrier that you have to go across as a professional cricketer. You know what you have been, you've learned since I was probably 8 years old, be training day in and day out to be a cricketer. And then you know that at one point I have to give up that. And you have to prepare yourself, you have to be ready to acknowledge that that change is going to happen. And then you make the decisions, how are you going to do that? Because Sandra rightly said, the fame is obviously is something that you will be recognized, but at the same time, it's a different fame. You know, you're not playing for your country anymore, and you're not going to be in the limelight anymore, which is brilliant. I enjoy that, not being in the limelight, not have to bear the burden of, you know, playing for Sri Lanka, which I've enjoyed, which I was very proud of. But it's a different thing, and you try and set yourself different goals beyond cricket and see what works for you. Where do you want to challenge yourself, whether it's business, whether it's a different area or whatever. So those are changes that you as individuals have to make and be ready for. So we made those adjustments quite early before we had to retire, and we were quite prepare and ready, and we knew the exact time that we needed to move on. So in life, I think you need to be bold to make those decisions and be ready for that. And in some areas, like I earlier said, you will make those mistakes, but you'll never learn without making mistakes. And change for anyone is wonderful. Don't be afraid of it. In which capacity, however you want to do, that's always going to give you a challenge to think about. And you should embrace that. Everyone says think outside the box. What is thinking outside the box? It's not, there's no box actually, you need to think laterally. But end of the day, there are fundamentals that guide you to think outside the box. Some of the destinations that you need to arrive is pretty much the same for a lot of people. It's how you get there. Whether the direction that you're taking is the right path, or can you find other ways and means of getting there. It's not about how quickly you get there, but getting there. And along the way, different challenges come. Life challenges. You know, it's family, it's marriage, it's kids, various other things. For everybody, because we're all humans. So how do you make those changes and at the same time get to that positions that you all strive for in life and be part of them? For me, something has worked. And this was told to me when I was about 19, 20, was a cricketer, ex-South African cricketer, didn't play much cricket for South Africa because of the apartheid. a guy called Barry Richards. So Barry did a coaching stint with us for 2 weeks. And initially when he said this, as a 20-year-old, I did not understand that. It took me some time to realize how strong those two, three words were. He said, control what you can control. It's pretty simple when you think about it. So initially I applied that for my cricket. So for me, the simple theory in that is that the more time that you spend thinking about uncontrollables, you're actually wasting. So for me, in a cricketing terms, if I'm touring England in early summer, it's going to be 10 degrees, 11, 12, on a good sunny day, it'll turn up to 15. It's cold, and they always put up in Durham, Derby, to make sure that we're freezing. So what can I control? I can control the things that I wear, the thermals, the sweaters, and all that, which is in my car. And how I mentally prepare myself. Go to England, go to Australia, we're going to get bouncy, grassy wickets. I can't control that. That's how they're going to prepare the wickets. So rather than worrying about that, let me prepare myself to play on those wickets. Focus on the little things that I can do. Challenge myself, change my technique, apply myself, different things. The media is going to take a center stage. They're going to, you know, abuse us, write us off. The fans are definitely going to abuse us. But I can control that. I don't have to read newspapers. I don't have to see the news. I can completely avoid that. I don't have to listen to the fans. I mean, English fans or the Australian fans. So, the thing is, I try to control things that I can't control. And that makes things much simpler. And you have better focus in driving yourself to push yourself. And that's one way of you thinking out of the box. Simple as that. So then I apply that for my day-to-day life, my everything, how I approach things. So I only control what I can control. And to leave a thought, I'm a very proud Sri Lankan. Very proud Sri Lankan. Does it drive me to be the race, the caste, or whoever we are? We're born to this island nation, and there's no other place for us to go. So I think let's control what we can control. Let's be the best we can be. And let us fight to take this country to the next level so that we could be very proud Sri Lankans. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful afternoon.